Just finished Fast and Furious 9. Got back home to LA, so I'm just chilling right now.
Oh, wow, you're working on that movie?
Well, I finished it. We finished it. I was in London for 7.5 months.
Wow.
We just got back like 3 weeks ago. And we had a couple weeks here at Irwindale Speedway. We did a big old flashback race sequence there.
Awesome. So are you like a stunt driver? Are you just doing like fight scenes or?
No, I'm the stunt coordinator and the second year director. I direct the action. I'm the action director now. When we did the Mortal Kombat, because on the first Mortal Kombat was 96 or 95, and the second one was 97. And I'd just been out of the Army for a couple of years when I got into the stunt business. So those are the ones. But back then I was a stuntman, you know, like, but yeah. I'm 52 now, bro, so it's hard to... It's hard to stunt still, you know.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little up there in the years. So now I hire all the badasses and have them do it for me.
That sounds like a good way to do things. Could you go into your MK history a little bit? Like, when did you first start getting into that?
Let's see. I did the first one. I was Johnny Cage's stunt double. Mm-hmm. And then I was Scorpion and Cyrex and Noob Saibot and one of the Barakas and an indie stuntman in the second one. And I was Kung Lao's double for the first 9 episodes of the TV series, and I was also Sub-Zero.
Yeah.
And I doubled a bunch of people on it as well. So that was my Mortal Kombat experience. They called me for the movie that they were going to do, but I was busy on a bigger show, so I couldn't go be the stunt coordinator and the second year director. They were offering me a job, but I couldn't do it.
Oh, wow. That would have been cool if you could have.
Yeah, I wish I could have, but you know, my impression is, because I'm still good friends with Larry Kazanoff, and I've seen a few renditions of this, the one that was on the internet a while back that Joe Tancheron or the Tancheron kid did, and some of my friends did it, Larnell Stovall and them did it.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be hard to capture what the original Mortal Kombat fans liked with a remake.
Yeah, everyone's got high expectations.
Yeah. Well, I hope it's good.
Was it hard to move around and do stunts and things like that in those costumes? What was that like?
The costumes, I can tell you the Cyrex costume wasn't very user-friendly. I got cut up pretty bad. My face cut from the inside of the helmet.
Oh, wow.
Wasn't really designed to fight in. And I got dumb. It wasn't a costume that people designed to fight in. It was difficult. And the Barakas, I don't know if you remember the Barakas in the second movie.
Yeah, it was horrible.
We shot the Cyrex sequence, we shot in London in the wintertime, so it was cold outside. But that Baraka sequence we shot in Thailand in August, and at this old rice factory, and it was like 110 degrees, 120 degrees in there.
Oh my goodness.
And we had those big rubber heads on, and those big rubber hands and those big rubber heads. It took like 3 hours to get that on every morning and 2 hours to get it off. It was hardcore. We were really, really tired.
I bet.
Yeah.
But I've seen photos of people that own the costumes now, and the mm-hmm. reptile outfit is faded so much that it looks yellow underneath, and it looks like it's been, like it was the Scorpion,
costume
painted over green, and like they reused it.
It could have been, but like I don't know about that for sure. Like, look, Larry Kazanoff was the producer. He had produced like 2 Lies. He had money. I think the budget on the second one was probably $25 million because we shot it in 3 countries. We shot it in London, Thailand, and in Jordan. We're all across the world doing it. So I think he probably, because I know that a lot of the costumes were costume design, I think he probably didn't recycle them for Mortal Kombat 2. Maybe on Mortal Kombat 1. I can't vouch for that for sure, but mm-hmm. I don't think for 2, because 2 had more of a budget.
Now, do you do any, like, Comic-Con appearances, or is that something you've ever thought about?
You know,
or?
I'll just be honest with you, I don't, and I'll tell you why. Like, I'm not really in this game for the fame. You know, like, I'm not an actor. I'm a stunt coordinator, action mm-hmm. director, or stunt performer. That was my go-to. And the real juice for me, what I love the most is going to cool places and doing a bunch of wild action shit with my friends and making a bunch of money.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the actors kind of bask in that fame thing. I was in the Army before this, dude, and I was an amateur fighter. Like, as an amateur fighter, you fight because you love to fight. You don't make any money, you know, like...
Yeah.
So for me, it's like, I'm not really into the fame, you know, like, I let the actors have that.
Well, I was only asking because, like, once a year or so, they have this thing called a Combat Con or something like that in Chicago, where they get, like, anyone that's had anything to do with Mortal Kombat together, and the fans can come out and meet and all that kind of stuff.
Well, put my name forward, and if they want to fly me out there, I'll come out, because I love Chicago. Good barbecue out there. Good
all right. Pizza. I'll pass that along.
Give them my number. Now you have my number. Give them my number. Tell them to call me and fly me out. I'll be happy to come out there and cut it up with you guys. We'll do shots. You do shots with fucking Cyrex. Tequila shots with Cyrex.
That'd be amazing.
Awesome.
You were, you know, the stuntman in the first two, and then you moved into actual acting as Sub-Zero for the TV show. Was that something that kind of threw you off? Like, did you enjoy the actual acting?
No, it was cool. And I got to say, you know, like the Scorpion in number two and Cyrex in number two, that was kind of the same thing because it was me the whole time. It wasn't doubling anyone. It was just me. But yeah, it was cool to like, you know, it was a cool thing. It was probably 1996 or 97. We were in Florida. Right after I finished that show, I went to Walker, Texas Ranger for like 3 years and did over 100 episodes of Walker. So I just had this mad run, and I was in Florida for like 9 months doing Mortal Kombat, and went right to Texas, where that's where I'm from originally, is Texas. Went right there for 3 years, which was super cool. But no, I was super Larry. I was in really good shape back then. Larry was like, you know, he was having a hard time casting someone for Sub-Zero, and he was hounding me about it. He's like, why don't you do it? You know, why don't you do it? And I was like, nah, I suck as an actor. I'm not any good. He goes, no, I'll do it. We'll coach you. It'll be great. You'll have fun. You know, it'll be something you can look back on when you're older. So he was right. You know, I enjoyed it. It was cool. Like all the guys that work for me now tease me about it, but you know, it's a lot of fun.
I thought you did a pretty good job.
No,
I mean, he's
cool.
Amazing, but I just thought you did a better job at playing that character.
Thank you, brother. That's awesome. I'm honored.
So out of all the stuff that you've done, like, what's the thing that you're most proud of, like, of all the stunt work and everything?
Oh, man, you know, I'm proud of the John Wick movies, because I just did John Wick movies. I'm also proud of a movie called Warrior Undisputed 2. There's a bunch of movies, because I've done, like, 130 or 150 films and over 300 episodes of TV. So I'm, like, proud of everything, but the ones that really stand out to me are movies like Warrior, or like John Wick 1, John Wick 2, you know, like Fast and Furious. I just did a movie last year called Bloodshot that's going to come out pretty soon. It's going to be pretty sick.
It's all good.
Like, I'm proud of all of it. You know, like, I never thought I'd be this fortunate to be able to do this kind of work. So, you know, getting that opportunity to do that kind of work for me was, you know, it's a blessing.
Yeah.
I was in the Army before this. So, you know, that's a whole different motherfucker within the Army. It's real shit, you know?
Yeah. You this guys are really, like, stuff, the real so heroes of the movies, too. Like, you guys don't get nowhere near enough credit that y'all fucking, you know, need.
Yeah, but you know, for me, it's like, again, it goes back to that actor thing. I don't really care. I'm not in it for the trophies or the fame, man. I'm in it for the money and the rush of doing some crazy shit with my friends. You know, and we get plenty of that. You know, so, like, I get paid that way. You know, like, the actors, all the stunt guys go, hey, we should get an Oscar. But they'll never give us an Oscar. And I always tell them why. I say, they'll never give us an Oscar because if they give us an Oscar, when it says the actor didn't do it and the director didn't think of it. And they're never going to share that because there's way too much ego in our business. Like, actors have a ton of ego, the directors have a ton of ego. So I just like, keep your ego, keep your trophies, give me the money and I'll be happy.
For real. So since you just wrapped up the Fast and the Furious, what do you have coming up next? You got anything down the pipeline?
Yeah, so I just finished Fast 9. I'm actually leaving for Atlanta on Thursday to do a movie called Samaritan with Stallone. It's a great script, Samaritan. MGM's producing it. We shoot it in Atlanta. And then, I've got a bunch of things cooking for next year. I'll probably be on that show for like 4 months, and I've got a bunch of stuff cooking for next year, big stuff.
Amazing, man. Busy man.
Yeah, man, I'm trying to keep myself busy, baby. Now it goes. Show business.
Yeah, well, thanks for taking the time to answer these for me, man.
No worries, bro. No worries. I'm just not really good at, like, I won't ever answer those things. And look, I'm honored that somebody's interested in Mortal Kombat still.
Yeah, there's a lot of us, man. I'm telling you. There's a lot still out there.
That's cool. Well, I hope they do you guys justice. I hope they do you guys right on the remake.
All right, man. Cool. Well, I'll let you go here.
Well, listen, man. No problem. You got my number. If you have any more questions, call me. Text me first and give me a call. I'll be happy to answer for you.
All right, man. I really appreciate that. You're cool as hell.
Yeah. Thanks, brother. Catch up. Later.
Later.